The Metro Manila Subway is an under construction underground rapid transit line Metro Manila, Philippines. The 36-kilometer line, which will run north-south between cities of Quezon, Pasig, Makati, Taguig, and Pasay, consists of 15 stations between the Quirino Highway and FDI Station. It will also become the country's second direct airport rail link after the North-South Commuter Railway, with a branch line to Naiya. On December 22, 2020, the transport agency announced that it had ordered 240 train cars for the upcoming Metro Manila's subway. Following a contract package signing between the Philippine government and the Sumitomo Corporation and the Japan Transport Engineering Company joint venture, the first phase of the project, which is four stations from East the Landlow to North Avenue, is already under construction, expected to be up and running 2022, with the rest of the subway scheduled to become operational by 2026. The deal has a total of 367 billion Philippine peso for the design, supply, installation, construction, testing, and commissioning of transit for the subway line. That's for 240 train cars and our 38-car train set. The Makati Intercity Subway is an 11-kilometer under construction underground rapid transit line to be located in Makati, Metro Manila, that will link establishment across the city's business district. It will be built under a public-private partnership program between the Makati City Government and the private consortium led by the Philippine Infoduct Holdings. Proponents of the subway are expected to be in construction on November 2020 and project's completion by the year 2025. Subway will cost 192 billion Philippine peso and expected to accommodate 700,000 passengers daily. It will also have 10 stations with connection to existing MRT Line 3, the Pasig River Ferry Service, and approved Line 9 of Metro Manila Subway. October 21, 2020, the city government of Makati has passed the ordinance authorizing the acquisition, the right-of-way covering the underground portion of 9 roads affected by subway project with Philippine Infoduct Holdings Incorporated. The roads that would be affected by the project are Hilpuyat Avenue, South Avenue, J.P. Rizal Avenue, J.P. Rizal Extension, Kalayaan Avenue, EDSA, C5 Road, San Guillermo Avenue, Vito Cruz, and Pablo Campo Senior Station. The Makati BGC SkyTrain is an under-construction monorail line may descend the Guadalupe and Makati and uptown Bonifacio in Bonifacio City Area in Taguig. The project consists of 2 kilometers public transit system between the vicinity of the Line 3, Guadalupe Station, and Port Bonifacio Town Mall area. It generally follows the existing road within the vicinity of J.P. Rizal Avenue, Lawton Avenue, 8th Avenue, and 38th Street. The construction of the SkyTrain is projected to cost 3.5 billion pesos and is set to commence within the first half of 2020. Infracorp will construct the monorail line for 2 years and plans to make the SkyTrain operational by the end of 2022. The phase 2 will consist of the expansion to extend the SkyTrain to Makati Central Business Districts. The expansion is also planned in Taguig that will connect Business District of Bonifacio Global City and the upcoming 2 South in FDI Taguig. The Metro Rail Transit Line Service, also known as the MRT7, is a rapid transit line under construction in the Philippines. When completed, the line will be 22.8 kilometers long with 14 stations. The line runs in the northeast-southwest direction, beginning at San Jose del Monte, Bulacan, after the North Avenue, Grand Central Station in North Avenue, Quezon City. The line will traverse Quezon City and Caloocan in Metro Manila, and it's envisioned to spur business and commerce in its intermodal terminal station in San Jose del Monte, Bulacan. According to the latest update, the project is 60% complete as of July 2020, with partial operation set to begin in 2021. The MRT7 project will cost an estimated 62.7 billion pesos, with additional plans are to lay for capacity expansion in order to accommodate possible increase in passenger ridership in the future. The North-South Commuter Railway, also known as the Clark-Colabor Railway, is a 148-kilometer urban rail transit line. Being constructed in Luzon, it will run from New Clark City and Capastarlac to Calamba Laguna, with 36 stations, with historic stations will be restored. The railway system is expected to cost 777.5 billion pesos, making it one of the most expensive projects of the build of Duterte's administration infrastructure program. Partial operation will begin 2021, and full operation is expected to begin by 2025. The project construction is divided into three phases. Phases 1, the 38-kilometer NSCR North, one commuter line between Tutuban in Metro Manila and Malolos in the province of Bulacan. Phase 2, the 53-kilometer NSCR North 2 regional line from Malolos, the Clark International Airport, to New Clark City. Phase 3, PNR Calamba, the improvement of the existing operation of the Tutuban Station to Calamba in the province of Laguna. It will also be linked to the existing and future railway lines such as Line 8 and Line 9. The Calamba-Bicol South Main Line in Calamba-Batangas City Railway future extension will also consist of three phases, NCR, NSCR South Phase 2. Calamba-Batangas City, the study also proposed the 58 kilometers extension of the NSCR to Batangas City. The NSCR North Phase 3 and Carlos Tarlac City propose the 38 kilometers 34 mile branch line that will split at El Carlos Pampanga. The line will have 12 stations and it will end in Tarlac City. NSCR North Phase 4, the Tarlac City, San Jose, the PNR has requested for feasibility study for commuter line connecting Tarlac City and San Jose. Nueva Ecija in 2019, the length of the line and the number of stations will be determined once the proposal has been submitted. The LRT1 Cavite Extension Project will extend the existing 20.7 kilometers Metro Manila line, serving the Metro Manila region of the Philippines by approximately 11.7 kilometers. It will extend the line from Baclaran to Bacoor City, Cavite. It will traverse to the city of Parañaque and Las Piñas, and it will end Barangay Niyo. City of Bacoor, once completed, the 11.7 kilometer extension will reduce the journey time between Baclaran and Bacoor from 70 minutes to approximately 45 minutes. The estimated investment for the project is 64.9 billion pesos, of which 25.4 billion will be funded by the Philippine government through Official Development Assistance, ODA. From the Japan International Cooperation Agency, the remaining 39.5 billion pesos will be raised through private sector investment. The LRT1 Cavite Extension Project is currently underway, with partial operation scheduled to begin in 2021. LRT2 East Extension is currently under construction, which add 4 kilometers of new lines, starting from the Eastern Terminal Santolan Station up to Masinag of Antipolo. The LRT2 East Extension project is now 92.1 complete, with its opening may happen in the second quarter of 2021. According to the Department of Transportation, however, two additional stations will be ready to accommodate riders within the first quarter of next year. These are Emerald Station in front of Robinson Metro East in Central Lucia Mall in Quinta Rizal, and Masinag Station, located before the Masinag Junction in Antipolo City, Rizal. The LRT2 East Extension Project shall ease the travel time from Rizal to Manila. Once this is completed, travel time from Recto to Masinag will be reduced to 40 minutes compared to 3 hours travel by bus or jeepneys. The 2.27 billion pesos project, whose construction started in 2017, seeks to extend the current railway system from Santolan in Pasig City to Masinag. Around 80,000 passengers daily will benefit from the additional station in the LRT2's current 240,000 capacity.